Welcome to the Windows Club. If Windows keeps changing your audio device frequently and you wish to stop Windows from doing the same, then please watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions and procedures. The first solution is to troubleshoot audio. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. In the settings menu, go to the system tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, scroll down and click on troubleshoot. Now select other troubleshooters. Corresponding to the playing audio troubleshooter, click on run. The second solution is to install Revert Windows updates and update the audio drivers. Nowadays, both of these can be done together. I'll explain the procedure. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. Go to the Windows update tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select advanced options. Click on optional updates. If any update is present, then please install it. Then return to the Windows Update window and click on Check for Updates. The next solution will be to switch to a different user account. Click on the Start button. After clicking on the Start button, you'll find your profile icon here. Click on your profile icon, and if another account is logged in, then you can change to that other account. Otherwise, you'll have to create it. The next solution will be to scan your system for viruses and malware. Search for Windows Security in the Windows search bar and open the application. After opening the application, go to the Virus and Threat Protection tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select Scan Options. Click on Full Scan and then click on Scan Now. The next and last option will be to monitor audio switching and switch it back. But for this, you will have to download a specific software. So go to solution number 6 of the original article and download and install this software named Sound Switch. Then open the software, go to the playback tab and uncheck the key associated with hotkey enabled. Then go to the profiles tab, click on add, create a profile. Let's say I'll make my name Karan. And once you create the profile and add all of the required columns, after this you can simply click on save and you will be able to resolve the problem. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, then please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.